Hi, boys and girls. So we are going to continue learning more about community helpers and specifically focus in on particular jobs. Today we're going to look at veterinarians. Veterinarians is a big word. Sometimes we'll also refer to the word as a vet. And today we're going to explore who veterinarians are, what they do, and how they help our community. Let's take a look at the read aloud book that we're going to read together today. Let's go. Book for veterinarians. So like I just mentioned, a veterinarian is, if we take a look at the picture here, is a doctor that takes care of animals. Today we're going to be reading this nonfiction book to see how veterinarians help animals and their community. Animal doctors. Veterinarians are animal doctors. They are also called vets. Vets help animals stay healthy. So here we have a little girl with her pet rabbit or bunny, and the doctor is using their tool to listen to the heartbeat of the rabbit. Vets, these doctors check animals with tools. Vets know how animals' bodies work. Why might a veterinarian check an animal's ear? So we see, look at the picture here. We can see them using a special tool to look through. So just like a doctor checks our ears, a doctor also needs to check animal ears to make sure that they are clean, that there's not any buildup of any kind, and to make sure that everything looks okay. And so just when our doctors do that for us, they do that for animals as well. Because remember, it's hard. We are able to share and tell what's wrong with us sometimes, but animals have a hard time. They can't talk, so they have trouble communicating sometimes if they are sick or not feeling well. And so this is why it's important to check everything out. Animals cannot say what hurts. Vets test animals. They find out what is wrong with animals. So sometimes the way they act, or the way maybe they purr, or they're very slow at doing things, sometimes that's a little sign that's telling us that maybe the animal's sick or not feeling good, especially if like they're not eating their food or very sluggish and slow. That could be an indicator that maybe something's wrong with your pet. Some vets treat big animals. This horse hurt its leg. The vet will fix it. So here we have the doctor coming to visit the horse and the stables. What are some other big animals vets might help? What do you think? What are some other big animals that they could possibly help? Think about when we learned about our zoo animals. What are some big animals that they could help? I was thinking of maybe an elephant, or a giraffe, or maybe a hippo. So those are just some that came to mind. Some vets work with small animals. People bring their pets to the vet. This vet gives a rabbit a shot. So we see in the left-hand side, the vet is holding it nice and carefully to kind of keep it safe, but is putting a needle in to maybe give it a type of shot to make it feel better, or a vaccine of some kind. I know that when I brought Shay to the vet, I had to give him several shots to make sure that he would be okay to go out, and that we would walk him, and that he wouldn't get sick. So a lot of animals need to get shots to make sure that they will stay healthy. Vets help wild animals too. This bird hurt its wing. The vet fixed it. Soon the bird will fly again. So vets help all different kinds of animals, from birds to cats to dogs to horses, and they're very caring and nurturing. Animals sometimes get scared. Vets talk to animals. They pet the animals. They keep animals calm. Why do you think visiting the vet scares animals? Sometimes, like when we go to the doctor, we get nervous because we might have remembered a time that we got a shot or we weren't feeling so great. And sometimes when we're not feeling good, we get a little anxious. So dogs and other animals have feelings and emotions just like we do. And sometimes they can get a little nervous or skittish. So vets have a nice way of calming and soothing animals by petting them or maybe giving them a little treat before they do something. I know that they would do that when I would take Shay to the vet as well. Vets work hard. They go to school for up to 8 years. They learn how to be vets. So many doctors have to go to school for a very long time, and it's important that as a doctor that they learn everything that they can to help treat these animals the best way that they can. So I'm thinking that doctors and especially veterinarians are extremely smart and hardworking. Vets help many animals. They keep animals healthy. So here we have some nonfiction text features, and it's labeling some of the veterinarian tools. We have a shot. There's a tool to check their ears. A lab coat. So that's a white coat. We mentioned before that in our other video that doctors will wear as an indicator that they're a doctor. A tool to check the heartbeat. And we have a table. So it's easy for the animal to be propped up, and it's easy for the doctor to examine the pet when it's sitting on the table. So we learned these important words: shot, test, veterinarians, and wild animals. So that was an awesome job reading our nonfiction book today on vets. And we learned today that they serve an important part in our community by keeping animals safe and healthy. Awesome job, boys and girls. I hope you enjoyed today's reading of learning about veterinarians. Keep up the hard work.